Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Mike Sims. I'm the fleet manager for MWI Pumps. And today we're going to be talking about the startup and operating of our Hydraflo pumps. And standing here behind me or next to me is one of our 2400D drive units, which will operate a couple different models of our hydraulic flow pumps, from a 12-inch HTC up to a 24-inch Hydraflo pump. And throughout this video, you're going to understand how these things operate and be able to maintain or operate one if you ever feel the need you got to have one. As like any startup of any hydraulic powered or diesel powered drive unit, the things that you want to cover before you do an initial start up the engine is go over all the fluid levels. You're going to want to make sure that the engine levels are good, the oil level, coolant level, hydraulic levels, that there's no signs of any kind of leakage or any issues that might prohibit the operation of this piece of equipment. So after an initial walk around for a startup procedure, at that point when you think everything is good to go, we would go ahead and go to our control panel, and at that point we'll go ahead and do a startup procedure. What we do is just go ahead and turn the key on. You'll hear the fuel pumps spool up, building pressure. After about 10 seconds or so, we can go ahead and start the unit. Once it starts up at idle, I usually let it run for about 30 seconds or so before I engage the hydraulic system. But while it's starting and idling, we're gonna go ahead and monitor the battery voltage, the oil pressure. There's the RPMs, we'll actually get and see a fuel burn, how much fuel we're burning per hour. And this here's the coolant temperature area over in here. This also will flash to a DEF level so you know how much fluid is in your DEF tank. Now, once it's started up, our throttle controls are these two buttons here. Arrow up throttles it up, arrow down throttles it down. So during the pre-startup, we were talking about checking fluid levels, and one of the crucial levels is the hydraulic level tank. This is a float gauge. It actually makes sure that we have enough hydraulic oil in the system to operate the pumps in a safe manner. And if any time we lose oil, that float will go down and trigger a ground signal and shut the engine down to protect it. So on pre-startups, you're running for a couple minutes, just a minute to let the system equalize. Make sure you don't lose oil. If a hose is empty and it's got to fill itself up, you'll see a bubble of air come down as it's filling that hose up, and you're going to want to top this off once you're up and running nonstop. And if you look over here, there's a bypass wheel. That's a flow meter wheel over there. That wheel is spinning. So all the oil now is 90% of it is being bypassed back to the tank. There is a small volume going down, spinning the impeller at a slow rate. But when we go ahead and close the valve and we engage the hydraulic system, we want to go ahead and bump this up to about 1,000 RPMs based on the size of the pump, and then slowly engage the hydraulics. We'll start to build pressure like you're seeing there. As long as we're not stalling the motor, we can go ahead and bump up a little more and just slowly keep building pressure till this knob is all the way closed. Now, as the knob's all the way closed, you can see the wheel has stopped spinning. So 100% of the oil now is going down to the pump head, and it is pumping water. We can go ahead and speed the unit up to a certain flow rate that we want, and now we're pumping water. Yes, we only got 1,300 PSI, but there's not a lot of load. Okay, so now we're gonna demonstrate an initial startup on a 2400 drive unit with a HAC 324 pump head. The engine's already started. It's running at idle. We're going to ramp it up to a safe RPM, 1,100 RPM, before we engage the pump. Once I start and engage the hydraulic knob, we'll do it slowly and build pressure to get water pumping. Once the knob is fully closed, we'll have a pressure reading there, and then we'll accelerate up to a good run speed that's going to maintain the level of water that they want to move. So now I will demonstrate. Slowly engage the hydraulics. You'll hear the engine start to load up as the impeller starts to spin faster. There it goes. And then we're going to go ahead and speed up. You can hear a little bit of load, but we get the RPMs up. The load's not so bad. And now the pump is running. Now at this point, We would monitor the system for a half hour to an hour, just check on it, just to make sure that our hydraulic oil is staying cool. The pump's submerged in the water, so it's got a cooler on it. That's what helps keep the hydraulic system operating at an optimum performance. Then after operation, if you want to shut down the unit, you just do it in reverse. You slow the engine down to a safe RPM so the engine doesn't stall, and then slowly turn the knob back and disengage the pump, letting the pressure come down to zero. And then like anything that has a turbocharger on it, we would want this engine to run for 2 minutes in a cool down period before shutting it off.
Feel free to contact us at mwipumps.com or the number that's going to be attached below in the video.